Hey guys, and welcome to another rock pooling video, where today you find me in Dawlish Warren, home to many amazing species, including fish, crabs, and weird sea slugs. So, let's just get into the video, and let me show you what creatures I managed to find. The first find of this rock pooling trip was this common shore crab, which had recently molted, as its shell was very soft. It was using the sea lettuce in this rock pool as a form of shelter.
Okay, I'm going to try and lift this rock here and let's see what sort of things are hiding underneath. Oh, we've got a little edible crab there. Lots of brawlclaw porcelain crabs, just a group of them over there. That's about it under this one. We've got a few more rocks to flip over. Let's see what we can find. Oh, we've got a little velvet swimming crab down there. Let's just get this rock. There we are. Little velvet swimming crab. Obviously very quick, very aggressive species found on our shores. He's gonna get ready to go. Yeah, there he goes. He's gone back under the rock. Let's just flip that back over. Oh, there's some sort of fish there. Don't know what that could have been. But other than that, just a few porcelain crabs, long clawed and broad clawed. Also got a strawberry anemone there, out of the water. I didn't actually get to see what type of fish was under that rock over there. We've got another rock here, close by. Let's see what's underneath. It's just a huge family of prawns. Lots of them down there. There's a big edible crab as well. Didn't see that originally. And by the looks of it, a big worm pipefish as well. I'll see if I can get some close up of that on the Olympus. That'd be cool. But yeah, just loads and loads of prawns.
This was one of the biggest worm pipefish I have ever found while rock pooling, and it was much more active than others I have found, which made it quite difficult to film at times.
You can clearly see why rock pooling in the summer is so easy. As you can see, the water is just almost crystal clear. Just makes it really easy to find loads of different sea creatures. Obviously, now that the warmer weather's here, there's just so much seaweed in the rock pools. In this one here, you've got a few different types. Over there, you've got your sea lettuce, your green seaweed there. There's a lot of red dulse around the edges of this pool. And then in at the bottom of the rock pool down there, you've got some giant fronds of sugar kelp. This particular rock pool here is one of my favourites at this beach, as you can see, there's a giant patch of the green and purple snakelocks and anemones there. Now, over the years I've come to this beach, it has rapidly grown. It started off just a little patch around here, but it is stretched all across the edge of this rock pool.
There was also a few snakelocks anemones nearby, with the much less vibrant grey and brown coloration. This is the first common blenny I've found in a while, which was surprising as they are usually very common in the rock pools of Dawlish Warren.
Okay, let's lift up some more seaweed, see what we can find in this rock pool. Some encrusting algae just over there. Let's try and see if something moves when I run my fingers through the seaweed. Doesn't look like it. As I said, there are like overhangs under these rock pools, so most of like the fish and the prawns will just immediately dart under there as soon as they can see the seaweed moving. But yeah, it's always a good idea to replace the seaweed how you found it, as the species that live in this pool will like need the cover to protect themselves from predators like the seagulls and other species like that.
Here you can see a patch of encrusting algae covering a couple of volcano barnacles. It's been a while since I filmed a velvet swimming crab underwater, as they are very fast and typically escape before I manage to focus on them. I found lots of edible crabs in the rock pools and under rocks during this trip. This species is one of the most common species found on UK shores, and one that is commercially important too.
I've mentioned this in a few of my previous rock pooling videos, but the Dawlish Warren rock pools are just completely covered in the invasive wireweed. As you can see, most of these pools here are just covered in it. This is an invasive species that came from Asia in the 1970s and has become established in most of the UK's coasts. As you can see, there's another big rock pool there. It's just completely covered the whole rock pool. Okay, the tide is starting to come in now. I was over by that big rock in the distance just maybe half an hour to 45 minutes ago, so it's coming in fairly quickly now. I'm just gonna keep working my way up the shore towards the upper shore to see what sort of sea creatures I can find.
Here is one of my best finds from this rock pooling trip, a crystal sea slug, which is a type of nudibranch. I found this species recently at another local beach called Coraton Cove, but it was great to find another one here. The crystal sea slug is a small species that can be found all around the UK's coasts, but can often be missed as they spend most of their time hiding under rocks or in dense patches of seaweed. Dwarf brittlestars are another species I commonly find at Dawlish Warren, but it can be difficult to spot them due to their small size and effective camouflage. The upper shore rock pools contain a wide variety of anemones, including beadlet and strawberry anemones. Here you can see a flat periwinkle, a colourful sea snail that can often be seen grazing on serrated wrack. Interestingly, most common hermit crabs I find at this beach are often found in upper shore rock pools. The upper shore rocks are almost completely covered in different types of barnacles and limpets, including the volcano barnacle, common limpet, and black-footed limpet. A species I wasn't expecting to find during this rock pooling trip was this grey chiton, a type of marine mollusk that I rarely find while rock pooling. Like other beaches around the UK, serrated wrack dominates the rocks and rock pools of Dawlish Warren. Although many people hate seagulls, I often enjoy watching them foraging for food in and around the rock pools. So, that's all for today's rock pooling video. If you enjoyed this video and learned something new, please leave a like and remember to subscribe to learn all about the creatures that inhabit our oceans. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.